Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This set of videos focus on tracking. In the previous videos, we focused on object tracking, like tracking a layer to a background in various scenarios. This time round, we'll replace a road sign with corner penning and four-point tracking. This is the same technique you would use to replace billboards, TV screens, etc. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. For this example, we have a driver's perspective looking at a road sign as he drives along. For the purposes of learning about corner penning and four-point tracking, we'll replace the large road sign. Select the segment in the sequence and apply a connect effects. Now drag out an action node from the node bin and place it into the connection. Go into the media library and drag the four-point track replacement into connect effects. Press one left arrow to hide the media panel. Select the action node and press Ctrl N to add a new media input. Just connect the fill of the media into the red front input of the media input node. Double-click on the action node and press Escape to see the action schematic. Now, when it comes to corner penning, you will manipulate the surface object directly and not the axis node like previous examples. So double-click on the image object to bring up the image tab with the surface menu. Looking at the surface heading, you will see a shape pull-down menu. Currently, it is set to flat. This is the standard flat layer surface that cannot be bent or twisted in 3D space. Switching the surface shape to bilinear converts the shape into a four-point shape that you can manipulate. So, for example, you can grab the points of the new sign and position it in the composite. Now, this would be fine if you were just pinning an image to a static frame. However, this is a moving shot. We need to get each corner to track the movement of the background. To do this, switch to the Vertices menu. The Vertices menu deals with two things. Firstly, the positioning of the tracking corners. And secondly, offsetting the image corners against the tracking data. This will all make sense once you see the workflow. First, we want to track the corners to the road sign. Hold Command and drag a box selection over the four corners to select them. The stabilizer is set to track mode, and click the button to enter the stabilizer. You now have four trackers, with each one mapped to the respective number on the keyboard. The tracker boxes don't acknowledge the original positioning of the corners, so we need to set it up now. The tracker boxes each represent a corner, and it must be placed in the following way. Tracker 1 is the top left corner. Tracker 2 is the top right corner. Tracker 3 is the bottom left corner. And finally, tracker 4 is the bottom right corner. If you place the tracker boxes in any other way, your image will come out twisted. Let's kick off the track and see what we get. Okay. So all the trackers except for tracker 4 tracked correctly. So let's fix the problem. Switch the selection mode to solo and press 4 to isolate tracker 4. The trees behind the sign are causing the defined pattern to change every frame. So we need to track elsewhere to get a successful track if this point always fails. Press the reset button and confirm the reset. This will only reset the isolated tracker. Now place the tracker box over the letter D. Press Analyze to calculate the track. You can see the track is lost halfway through because the defined pattern was getting larger. So scrub to the last good frame before the jump. Press Snap to see the new reference pattern. Start the track again, and it will overwrite the bad keyframes with new ones. so that is the bottom right-hand corner taken care of. Switch the selection mode back to selected. So this has given us the positioning of the corners. But as you will see in a moment, we need to offset the image corners to fit the sign accordingly. Press the return button to exit the stabilizer. Scrubbing the time bar, you can see that the tracker boxes have assigned their exact positioning to the corners of the image. To offset the corners of the image from their tracking data, we can use the offset sliders. You can see that they appear to be slightly fiddly because you are trying to place corners which are counteracted by their tracking data. There is an easier way to work with the offsets. Switch to the media menu and ensure the new sign media is selected in the media list. Select the action schematic and press F1 to see the media front view of the selected media. Go back to the object menu and enable Edit Offsets. This will give you little crosshairs in the media front view. You can adjust them in the media view and see how they update the offsets in the composite. So you can now massage the corners to match the shape of the sign without affecting the tracking data. Once you are done, turn off the Edit Offsets. The final things to do are to sort out the filtering and crop or mask the image to integrate the new sign. Go to the Image Surface menu and set the filtering from Linear to EWA plus Linear. That makes things clearer. Now we'll crop the sign in this case. Switch back to the Media menu. Double-click on the crop boxes to enable cropping. Now there is a bounding box in the media view. Hold Shift and drag the box to proportionately crop the sides. Now hold Shift Option and drag the box proportionately to add softness to the sides. The top media needs to be cropped a bit more, so click and drag the top edge until it fits the sign. Play around with it until you are happy with the result. Finally, hold Option and drag the blur a small amount to match the shot. One final tip, and it is a big one. If you've created your four-corner pin and you would like to shift your image around within the track, you can do this using a source node in Action. Go back to the Action Schematic view. Switch to the Action Bin. With the media selected in the media list, press S for Source Node. Drag out the Source Front node, and this will create a pre-composite with the selected media. There are tons of things you can do with source nodes, but in this case, double-click on the Axis node. Adjust the image to your liking until it fits into the sign. So that's looking really good. Exit Connect Effects and press Render to process the final result. So now you're on the road to four-point tracking. Let's move on to the next example, where we will use the paint tool to remove unwanted markings on a moving vehicle. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.